Hey techies, Anthony from HNE Tech here, and today we're taking a look at the CyberPower battery backup with surge protector. This is the 650 volt one, and what we're looking at is the actual box. We're going to have to split to a different video for the actual part itself because it is obviously in use. But the box, of course, says protects electronics from damaging surges and stay powered during outages. There should be an asterisk. Protects computers, modems, routers, satellite, cable, game console, smart home devices, which is pretty much everything I have connected to it. 8 grounded outlets, assuming that the outlet you plugged into is grounded. 890 joules of surge protection. So far, so good. I have 2 of these units. They both stopped anything from being damaged during the most recent 3 power outages. 2.4 amp USB charging ports. It has 2 of them. There is an equipment guarantee. Hopefully I'll never have to use it. Same thing with the warranty and Energy Star certified. It basically is like it's not even there. So from the box, the side of the box is pretty much everything it's saying, you know, here. It says you can run a 6-watt router for 315 minutes. Well, that's the rating. See, I recorded the video of the actual bit with stuff hooked up to it. Not looking at the top of this box because I feel like 6 watts, that is like how many watts is a normal LED light bulb now? Like, so we're saying like 350 minutes for an LED light bulb. A computer at 40 watts, 66 minutes, workstation 35 minutes, and a home computer, yeah, that's about right. So pretty much says all the same stuff on the sides, and then of course here it just breaks down things more in dimensions and weight. This thing is a chunky boy, and pretty much everything else you need to know. And inside the box with the power supply or backup battery, of course, was a bunch of foam because you want that thing to be protected. And it also comes with a USB-C to A cord. I'm not quite sure exactly why. I'm sure if I would read the instructions, which you see are still in the bag, then I would have learned. But that is essentially what comes with it. And here we are under one of my desks. And of course, it's a little bit dusty because, well, it's under one of my desks on the floor. And to explain that real quick, that's why I have these outlet covers. Because whenever you have something on the floor, and you really should never have electronics on your floor because of static, but as you can tell, I really don't have the space to put it on a shelf or anything because my feet go like right here, because this is the chair pad, or chair, whatever the thing is called. Anyway, it is just a huge brick. Now, of course, it's a battery and it's charging and that is what it's supposed to do. And this on this side is the battery backup stuff. And then this on this side is the pass-through. Now, the way this works is, of course, there's a power button, there's a reset. If it has like a overcharge or a power surge, you can just reset it and then kick it back on. 2 USB ports, those are 2.4 amp, and then the outlets are the standard 120s that we have here in the United States. And this, of course, is a 650 volt or VA, whatever they want to call it. And to give you an example of what I have hooked up here, this is my computer. This is my TV setup, and then this is my alarm clock. So I don't have a lot plugged into here. I was, despite whatever it says on the box, 300 and whatever, or 400 and whatever minutes, it really determines how long this thing can stay on is based on what is connected to it. So we had a power outage. We've had 2 or 3 since I've had this thing. And this thing lasts a few hours with just a clock and a fan or a light connected to it. So that's pretty good. So on my pass-through, I have my Google Home. And I mean, 'cause if the internet's out, why do I need this? Like, so I don't care if it goes out. And of course, surge protected outlets, battery supported outage, outlets with surge protection. And it's a decent system. It does what it's supposed to. It lasts as long as, the most recent power outage was 4 hours. So it kind of literally died about an hour before the power came back on. So I guess after about 200-ish minutes. So when it says it lasts 315 or 450, whatever the battery says it lasts,
I think it is absolute bare minimum of like a low wattage, low powered light. You know, I don't know how they come up with these ratings. But as you see, this is rather straightforward. It, of course, draws from an outlet, and what happens is as it's charging, it'll pass through, and then once it's fully charged, and then it just passes through until it needs to pull power. So what happens when it pulls power is it will do a number of different beeps. Usually, it'll do a couple of beeps every 30, 45 seconds, indicating that it is now using battery power. But when it gets near to drainage, because it's an annoying fast beep. Now, the funny thing about our power outage recently was that it was actually started off as a brownout, which means we were still getting some power. So there's, you know, before the brownout, I disconnected or turned off everything else to make sure this battery could last as long as possible, because I didn't know how long the power was going to be out. And even at brownout conditions, it was beeping like it was running out of juice, despite the fact that it was still trickling in power. And, you know, it was very weird. But what it tells me is in a brownout case, it'll indicate when you're using more power than the battery actually has on it. But once the power went completely out, and then it was operating in the normal, okay, it's beeping every 30 to 45 seconds. I have this one here, which is under the desk in my bedroom, and then I have the one in my office, which is next to the desk. It's too cluttered there to be showing off that one. But that one is a similar situation where I have the computer set up, I have the light set up for the box display, and then there's another setup for my printer. So these are great. You do not want to overload them. You want to make sure you're securely plugged into some type of surge protected outlet, or even at least a grounded outlet, because you want to ensure that if there is a power surge, you don't fry this thing, you don't fry your equipment.
With that said, tell me in the comments what you thought about this device. Are you planning to get one? Do you have any questions? Let me know and I will try to answer them. Thanks for watching, and please remember to like and subscribe.